हॅलो एव्हरीवन, माय सेल्फ गणेश ढवळे, वर्किंग ॲज ॲन असिस्टंट प्रोफेसर इन मेकॅनिकल इंजिनिअरिंग डिपार्टमेंट, ब्रह्मदेव दादा माने इन्स्टिट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नॉलॉजी, बेलाटी, सोलापूर. टुडेज टॉपिक फॉर द सेशन इज नथिंग बट लिनियर प्रोग्रामिंग प्रॉब्लम. द टॉपिक इज फ्रॉम द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ ऑपरेशन्स रिसर्च. ऑपरेशन्स रिसर्च इज अ सायंटिफिक मेथड ऑफ प्रोव्हाइडिंग द एक्झिक्युटिव्ह डिपार्टमेंट्स विथ अ क्वांटिटेटिव्ह बेसिस for the decisions to be taken regarding the operations under their control, and for that purpose they are using the models. Models are nothing but the idealized representation of the real life situation. You can say that a map or a chart is a model. Its objective is to provide a means for analyzing the behavior of the system to improve its performance. Okay, coming back to the linear programming, it is a technique to provide a particular plan of action for the independent activities. In the business or economic situations, the biggest problem is nothing but the planning activity, and in the name itself means the programming is another word for the planning. Okay, so planning is the most important in the business or the economic situations. So linear programming is concerned with the planning activity. Okay, linear programming problem involves three basic aspects. The first one is nothing but the decision variables. Or the activities involved in that problem. So the decision variables are the most important aspect from the linear programming problems. These decision variables should be interrelated with each other in terms of the availability of the resources. And again, these decision variables should be controllable and they should be the fixed one. Okay. Next, second aspect of this linear programming problem is nothing but the objective. Or you can say it as a goal. A particular problem which should have the particular objective means the goal to be achieved by the solution of that problem. The third aspect, nothing but the constraints, or you can say that the limitations. Or the conditions. Certain limitations to the available resources are there, such as the labors will be there, some raw material will be there. So there are certain limitations for that. Okay, so these are the three main aspects of the linear programming problem. The next one is some assumptions to be made in the linear programming problems. The first assumption is nothing but the certainty. All the parameters must be known and fixed in these types of problems. Second one is divisibility. In this divisibility, you should have the knowledge regarding the decision variables, in that the solutions to these decision variables will be in terms of fractions, or it can take on any value. and it will be non-negative only. Okay, so it can take on any value. It means that you will be having the fractional values also in the solution. But if it is necessary to have the integer values, the problems should be considered for the integer values again. Okay, so that is nothing but the divisibility. Third one, that is nothing but proportionality. All the decision variables should be interrelated with the objective function and the constraints also. So they should be proportional with the values of objective function and the constraints. And the last one is nothing but additivity. The last one is nothing but the additivity. Suppose there are two products A and B, and combiningly they have the profit of some value. If we will add the profit of A and B individually, it should come the same value as that of profit of both. That is nothing but the additivity. Okay. The next point is nothing but mathematical formulation of the linear programming problems. In these mathematical formulation, there are some steps to be followed. The first step is nothing but identify the key decisions to be made by using the real life situations. The key decisions to be made. Second one, to identify or to set the decision variables. Decision variables to identify and designate them with the symbols. For example, xj, to identify the decision variables and to designate them with the symbols. Third step is nothing but state some infeasibility or feasibility of the situations. Suppose that the values of xj should be, if we want to say that they should be non-negative, we have to say like that it should be greater than or zero. So the feasibility has to be considered while the mathematical formulation of the problems. Next, fourth one, identify the constraints of the problem and express them in the linear inequalities or the equations. Constraints, and the last step is to identify the objective function. The last step is to identify the objective function and express them or express that in terms of the equations. So these are the different steps in linear programming problems. So we'll have one problem and we'll consider this linear programming problem. So consider one problem. There are three departments in the organization. There are three departments in an organization. First one is weaving, then processing, and packing. And in such a problem, there are three types of materials they are going to be produced. The first one is nothing but suitings, shirtings, and the woolens. So the problem is, for 1 meter of particular material, they will be using some time for 1 meter. Particular department will be using some time for that material. So for suitings, weaving can take 3 minutes. For suitings, processing requires 2 minutes. For suitings, packing require 1 minute. Okay, in such a format, shirtings will have 4 minutes for weaving, 1 minute for processing, and 3 minutes for packing. Same way, woolens will require 3 minutes for weaving, 3 minutes for processing, and 3 minutes for packing. And the profit they will earn through these is nothing but profit they will have per meter. Again, it is in meters. Per meter, they will have 2 rupees as a profit in suitings, 4 minutes as a profit in shirtings, and 3 minutes as a profit in woolens. And particularly in a week, these departments have some availability. So availability of the departments in minutes. So the availability of a weaving department in a week is nothing but 60 hours. So we'll be multiplying 60 by 60, it will be coming in minutes. Processing department will be having 40 hours. And packing department is having 80 hours. So this is the problem to be considered in LPP, linear programming problem. So we have to formulate mathematical, we have to do the mathematical formulation of this problem. Okay. So the first step in mathematical formulation is nothing but to set the the first step was study the given situation and find the key decisions to be made. So in this problem, the key decision is to find the rate of production, rate of production in a week. You have to find the rate of production in a week to maximize the profit, right? You have to maximize the profit and you have to find the rate of production by using these three departments. This is the first step. So the key decision is to be made to decide the rate of production in a week. The second step is to identify the decision variables. Getting it? To identify the decision variables and designate them with the symbols. So for suitings, we'll use as X1. For shirtings, will use as X2, and for woolens will use as X3. Okay, so this is the second step. Third step is nothing but to state the feasible alternatives, right? The third step is to state the feasible alternatives. So ultimately the alternatives will be x1 should be greater than or equal to 0, x2 should be greater than or equal to 0, and x3 should be greater than or equal to 0, as there should be the non-negative values of the products to be produced. Okay, so ultimately these are the feasible alternatives which we will be using. The fourth step is nothing but identify the constraints in the problem. So the constraints in the problem are nothing but the availability of time for particular departments. Ultimately the availability of time or availability in minutes of the particular department. So the constraints we can say that are nothing but in the first shootings the availability was 60 into 60. So it will give you 3600 minutes for weaving, it is 3600 minutes. For processing, the availability was 2400 minutes, and for the packing the availability of time is 80 hours, means 4800 minutes. So these are nothing but the constraints for that problem. And the last one is identify the objective function and express it as a linear function of the decision variables. So to identify the objective function, we are knowing that we have to maximize, the fifth step is we have to maximize the profit. So the objective function will be designate it as a Z. We have to maximize the profit. So ultimately by selling one suiting we'll be getting 2 rupees as a profit. So we'll be adding it as a 2x1. By selling 1 meter of the shirtings we'll be earning 4 rupees as a profit. So it will be 4x2. And by selling 1 meter of the woolens we'll be getting it as a profit as 3 rupees. So ultimately 3x3. So this could be your objective function that you have to maximize. You have to maximize Z, that is a profit, 2x1 plus 4x2, 3x3. And the constraints for that will be3x1 plus 4x2 plus 3x3. That should be less than or equal to 3600. So how it has came? Ultimately you will be requiring 3 minutes for suitings, 4 minutes for shirtings, and 3 minutes for woolens in the process of weaving, right? So ultimately the weaving has the time limitation as 3600 minutes. So ultimately 3 minutes for suiting, 4 minutes for shirtings, and 3 minutes for woolens. Ultimately by using this you should have the constraint or the limitation as you will require the time which is lesser than 3600 minutes. Same way for processing, it will be 2x1 plus x2 plus x3, and the time limitation for the processing, it is 2400. Same way for packing, it will be x1 plus 3x2 plus 3x3 should be less than or equal to 4800 minutes. So ultimately in the mathematical formulation you have to maximize the objective function Z, that has a profit, then the limitations for this one are, and again the alternatives are, so this is nothing but the mathematical formulation of the linear programming problem. Thank you.